Jerry 501. I'm in the casual truth. This is dated June 10th, 2010. Switzerland's bizarre nuclear bunker law. It's difficult to know whether to laugh or admire. To this day, every home in Switzerland has to have a nuclear bunker, or at least access to one. The law was designed to protect people against the security threats of the Cold War, which ended more than 20 years ago. And despite the war finishing, Switzerland's reason for keeping the rule is simply a case of why stop now? The law was introduced in 1963 to ensure all Swiss residents have protection against a nuclear attack. Each household can choose to build a nuclear bunker in their basement or pay for access to a community bunker. Supplies inside should last up to several weeks. The law seems to reinforce Switzerland's determined belief that it can protect itself. For instance, the Swiss still teach their school children that the reason the Nazis didn't invade them in World War II was due to their superior mountain tactics, and not the fact that the Nazi money was stored in their banks. Whatever the mentality, the bunker law has certainly led to some impressive feats of engineering. Most notably, the Sonnenberg Tunnel. When the town of Lucerne was lacking bunker capacity for several thousand people in the early 1970s, they copied an idea from the British who hid in London's underground stations during the Blitz, Germany's bombing campaign. The Lucerne local government redesigned their new 1.5-kilometer motorway tunnel to also serve as the world's largest nuclear shelter. Each of the tunnel's 1.5-metric-thick, 350-ton steel doors ensured it was capable of withstanding a 1-megaton nuclear bomb a kilometer away. That's 70 times more powerful than the Hiroshima bomb. Inside were bunk beds for up to 20,000 people, a mini hospital, a prison, night and day lights, and a command post. Massive air filters were installed to supply the inhabitants with 192 cubic meters of non-radioactive air each day. Despite the achievement, though, doubt set in about the tunnel's logistical and engineering capabilities after some organizing difficulties and the doors failed to close properly during a 1987 test drill. As a result, the tunnel's capacity was downscaled to 2,000 people in 2005. Even so, the country still has over 270,000 bunkers capable of accommodating the entire Swiss population of 7.8 million people. Some places even have the luxury of choice for those who don't get along. But such protection and security comes at a price. Building an underground bunker equipped with blast-resistant concrete adds about $6,000 or 4% to the cost of an average house. So why carry on this doomsday requirement when the threat was largely disappeared? The government's reasoning is that they've already built all these bunkers, so they might as well just carry on. Besides, a new threat could emerge at any time. The opposition in Switzerland say this is ridiculous. They believe the bunkers are useless against the modern threats of terrorism, meaning all they are doing is building expensive wine cellars. Indeed, wine cellars, ski storage seem to be their most popular function these days. Other uses include a room for pool tables, band practices, wrestling competitions, bowling alleys, and saunas. One man even converted his into a giant pizza oven. The Swiss government actually encourages those with bunkers to use them for alternative purposes. The way they see it, a bunker used is a bunker maintained. The only requirement is that they must be able to be cleaned up and returned to emergency condition within 24 hours. Beds in place, bare walls, no oxygen, depleting carpet, and to contain the necessary food, water, and medicine. The idea behind the time frame is that given modern communication systems, the government should be able to provide a public warning 24 hours before any attack. The Swiss authorities still run regular tests to make sure their sirens work and that all the bunkers are up to scratch. It's a type of paranoia that the rest of the world probably finds amusing, but you never know. The time may come where the Swiss end up having the last laugh, literally. Oh. that was interesting. I had heard that there were massive amounts of bunkers all over Europe. Or, I mean, all over Switzerland, I'm sorry. I guess the most interesting one is the one of their version of Fort Knox. And they are using it for a data safety area in case of another world war, that everything, all their data that's above ground will be safe. They call it Swiss Fort Knox. You can see they've got water, they've got tunnels, they've got everything. Pretty amazing. And this really does kind of coincide with one of my last videos that I made about a story that somebody told me that I taped that was in regards to a military bunker where the gentleman had delivered a load, an undisclosed load, to this underground city. And everybody acts like it's such a big deal. But in Switzerland, it's not a big deal. Of course, the difference is there is obviously they're trying to protect their citizens. Whereas here in the United States, they only want to take those people that are deemed worthy of surviving. The rest of us are just eaters. So, might be time to take a little vacation to Switzerland. See what my options really are for survival. Anyway, I will put up the links. You can take a look. There's tons of pictures of bunkers in here. Kind of cool looking. Alrighty, as always, God bless.